video, so share it and see it on your Facebook page. My name is Kelly Jackson. I am the founder of Jim Japan. If you don't know what Jim Japan is basically a mission ministry, and we are spreading the gospel from Japan into the earth. Currently, right now, me and my family, we're about to embark on a trip to Japan at the end of the month, July 30th. So, that's not really what I wanted to talk about. I shared a little bit about some things that the Lord has shared with me, and I wanted to jump right in because there's a lot of things that are being expressed, a lot of emotions that are being expressed about various different topics, and I think this is a timely message for just the average person. You know, you hear the words from pastors and teachers and prophets and all this other stuff, and then there's, you know, the news, the media, your co-workers. There's a lot of people saying a lot of different things. And at the end of the day, we all kind of come down to, okay, now, what do I do with this information? So I was actually thinking kind of devotional, and one of the scriptures I like to do, I just stepped off the devotional and followed the Lord and what he's saying to the scripture. And I really wanted to share with you guys wisdom of God in such a moment where it's just kind of like, hey, pay attention. If you want to take notes, or if you just wonder what I'm going to be talking about, basically I'm going to be talking about beware the leaven of the Pharisees and Sadducees. There's a scripture in Matthew 16, going to start with verse 5. Actually, I have it here, so I'm going to go here on the iPad, and I want to make sure I actually read the scripture correctly. I encourage you as well, if it's your Bible, you know, have another device that you can look at the scripture. I would like to say before I read scripture, that if you are led astray or you're deceived and you're not reading the scripture for yourself, it's going to fall. So make sure that you're not just looking at me. What I'm saying, but you're actually looking at what the scripture is saying. So anyway, again, that's Matthew. Again, that's Matthew chapter 16. And we're going to start with verse 5. And so before this, just a little backstory, before this, Jesus kind of had an interaction with the Pharisees and the Sadducees, and they were asking him to show them a sign from heaven. So he has a conversation with him, leave that for yourself. After that, it says this in verse 5, again, Matthew 16, starting in verse 5. When the disciples reached the other side, they had forgotten to bring any bread. They don't got no bread. They get to the other side of the river, lake, sea, wherever they were. And they're like, yo, you forgot to bring bread. So Jesus said to them, verse 6, Jesus said to them, oh, I'm sorry, I'm reading out of the ESV, just so you know. And yeah, Jesus said to them, watch and beware of the leaven of the Pharisees and the Sadducees. And they began discussing it amongst themselves, saying, we brought no bread. So he says, hey, watch out for the leaven of Pharisees and Sadducees. Beware. Watch and beware. And so leaven, for you that don't know, leaven is the thing in bread. Now we call it yeast and helps rise, all that stuff. But it's basically associated with bread. In this Jewish time, it's associated with bread. Anytime you talk about leaven, somebody's making some type of cake or bread or bun or leaven. And so for them, they're like, yo, like, man, we forgot. We really forgot the bread. Like, what are we going to do? They're talking amongst themselves. And come to me, we've got no bread. I would have explained. Verse 8, but Jesus, aware of this conversation that they're having, he said, oh, you of little faith, why are you discussing among yourselves the fact that you have no bread? Do you not remember the 5 loaves for the 5,000? And how many baskets you gathered? Verse 8, or the 7 loaves for the 4,000? And how many baskets you gathered? How is it that you fail to understand that I did not speak about bread? Beware the leaven of the Pharisees and the Sadducees. Then they understood that he did not bread that the teachers and the Pharisees and the Sadducees. Okay, so there's a scripture. Goes down a little bit and having a conversation with them. He's like, yo, guys, you are leaven and Pharisees and Sadducees. Their head, if you're leaven, it automatically gets back to the lead. Yo, we forgot bread. So in this time period, like, bread would be here, like, bread would be like the go-to thing. If you got bread, you're good. Like, right now, like, some nations with rice or, like, pasta or fast food, like, just something quick that you can grab, and it'll, you got, it's cheap, you can just eat it real quick, make it real quick. Everybody had bread. And they forgot bread. So they're trying to figure out, basically, their basic needs. You know, the Lord's Prayer, you know, give us this day our daily bread. Basically, like, hey, give us our bread. Focusing on what they need, focusing on, yo, this is the situation for God. Jesus has to break it down for you. You guys are worried about bread, and it's like you've forgotten we did these other things that happened. You forgot 5 loaves and 7 loaves. You forgot how many it fed, and you forgot how much was left over after. He repeats himself. Where the leaven, the Pharisees, and Sadducees. And so what God was really showing me that in this time, like, there's a lot of people that have need of many things. Many, many, many things that we have need of and that we're seeking for and that we're trying to figure out. And he wants us to not get caught up in trying to figure everything out. Especially in this time. It's the time to lean in, trust in God. Lean in, understand who he is. And so, I always like to make sure that I'm saying and communicating things that God has told me to say. So if I pause, looking down my notes and saying, okay, Lord, you want me to say that. But anyway, one thing that's really, really, really interesting that God was kind of highlighting in Jesus, saying that Jesus kind of highlighting in this section that he showed to me was that, like, when you look back in the Old Testament, which is really, when you think about the priests and Levites, everybody that had to, like, keep order and maintain all these different sacrifices, and the lineage that led into the Pharisees and Sadducees, and following the law, being the keepers of the law, all that stuff, they had no choice, really, except to pay attention to detail and what we had and what we didn't have, and is this the right way, and is this done the right way, because it could equal, you know, some curses upon their own land, curses upon their people, curses upon themselves. They could die in some circumstances if they weren't doing things according to what the law had said. And so this is the root of the tree that is the faith of Sadducees. And at that time, it was good because it was showing the Israelite people how to be obedient and obey God. So they literally do exactly as he said. Now, obviously, through time, they kind of got into, all right, I do all these things because, and therefore, once I do all these things, then I'm righteous and I'm good. God kind of flipped that whole thing. It's like, no, you're righteous, you're going to save you, etc. But you have to think, in their mindset, when they're questioning Jesus, when they're trying to poke holes in his theology, as we would say nowadays, when they're trying to figure out, like, who's this guy, what are you really about, they are coming from a place where they had to figure it out. They had to make sure. They had to sit down and be like, okay, do we have the type of bread that we're supposed to have? Do we have enough fire? Do we have enough this? Do we have, is this in the right place? Is this in the right, do I have all my affairs set in order? Is it, are the bells on my, they had to figure out all these things. And Jesus here said, you are the leaven, and the Pharisees and Sadducees. Watch out. No one comes to be on you and grow on you. There's a picture of me and I saw recently, and it was a picture of, like, all of this, like, dough and, like, that was spilling out of a dumpster. And at the bottom of it, it's like, when you throw out, just because you throw out, you know, bread with leaven in it, just because you throw out bread or something, it doesn't stop the yeast from growing it or making it rise. And so it's like someone threw all this stuff out, but I guess they messed it up, and they forgot to realize, no, this is actually really, actually done better. I mentioned that because in the same way, it can be very, very, very simple for us to just forget about it all and, like, get so caught up in trying to figure out what we're supposed to do, how do I make these things be, how do I make this and that, and try to figure it out ourselves, and we get caught up in the level of the things we do. So trying to figure it out, trying to make sure we're doing this, trying to make sure things are all good. So Jesus actually telling him this. He's telling himself that this in the midst of the time they're trying to figure out the whole bread situation. Oh, you forgot bread. What are you going to do? They don't need it for that bread. How are you going to make this work? And then God's like, yo, I've done all these things. Look to all the things that I've done. Let that encourage you. I'm going to continue to do them. Because not because back then I wanted to do them that way for a certain reason because I like doing that, but because that's who I am. I am your provider. I'm going to give you the things that you need. The only thing you have to do, check this out, the only thing you have to do is be obedient. And that's crazy because it's like it started off with obedience. All the Israelites had to do, all the priests and the Levites had to do was be obedient. And then, and now with the disciples, when Jesus comes on the scene, it's the same thing, the same starting point, being obedient. God's going to challenge me in the area of faith and like having faith and like believing for things and et cetera, et cetera. As you know, especially for us, like we're moving and there's a two-step and a lot going on, blah, blah, blah. And it's just kind of like, okay, well, let me just muster up some faith and whatever. And it's like, he's reminding me, like, okay, that's good. Muster up your faith, you know, muster seed, all that stuff. Have the faith. But also remember, just be obedient. Do exactly what I say, and it will be. What he showed me, is really cool. So he mentioned these two, moments, miracles that have happened. He's like, hey, you gotta remember this. Bread here, and then we expanded it, and we fed all these people, and then we had leftovers. And then another time, same thing, some more bread. And I was looking at those moments, and I was wondering, okay, why? I mean, I know they both have bread in them, but, you know, what's the significance of these? And he was showing me personally, like, he was like, look at what the disciples did. They were trying to figure it out. At first, hey man, what about this? Send the people away, blah, blah. They're trying to get them caught up. They're trying to figure things out. And then Jesus says to them some instructions. If they continue, like, well, you know, like, this is what it is. No. They obeyed. And so what he's been really showing me is, first and foremost, as far as beware of leaven of the Pharisees and Sadducees, if you're in a situation right now and you're trying to figure every detail out, you're trying to get everything done, in your own mind, you're trying to sketch it out and figure out, okay, if I put this over here and blah, blah, and you're not taking time to pause and be like, God, what do I do? Beware, watch out for the leaven and the Pharisees and Sadducees. Beware of trying to figure everything out. Because then it's going to only be your strength. We can only do so much. And God knows where you need to be, where the money needs to be, how you need to operate. He knows exactly how to get you through this situation and what movements to make. It's kind of like this. We're playing that game Hole in the Wall. I don't know if you ever heard of it. People try to make funny shapes to fit through this like foam thing, and if they don't make the right shape, they get knocked into the water. We're trying to play Hole in the Wall blindfolded by trying to figure out, okay, if I feel it, if I try to figure out what the shape is before it hits me, then maybe I'll be able to fit through it. And it's like, yo, just pause and let God tell you what shape to make. And then you get through it. In the same sense, worrying about your bills, worrying about doing all these things, you need to be spending time, prayer, and the Lord to let Him tell us what to do. Because when the disciples did this, they were able to see the miracles of Jesus Christ. They were able to see the miracles of their Messiah right before them when they were obedient. Peter said to Jesus, if it's you, say, come. And they're in the boat, and the storm's going crazy. He didn't step out of the boat until Jesus said, it's me, come on out. And so then he was able to be a part of the miracle. But as we all know the story, if you don't know the story, I'm kind of spoiling it, but the moment he started looking and trying to figure out, like, okay, how is this possible? You know, a lot of people say, couldn't have died without Jesus. But he started focusing on the wrong thing, trying to figure out, okay, what's going on? He starts to sink. The moment that we are obedient to what God is saying, that is when we get into the place where we're activating the miracles that God is doing in this earth. We can be a part of it just by simple obedience. And so, it's really awesome because what the unhindered obedience, where you are knowing who he is. You've got to spend time with the person to know who they are. In the same way with the relationship you have with God. You've got to spend time with him. You've got to know how he operates in your life. The way that he tells me to do certain things, the way that he is with me, the way that he affirms me and affirms me is not necessarily going to be the same for you. But we have that separate thing that we can have here, and there's going to be similar things that we'll be able to kind of like go back and forth on. Like, oh yeah, oh my goodness, that's so crazy. But as we get to know him more and more, this is what's going to yield to that unhindered obedience, which is going to build up that faith, because that faith isn't, will God do this certain thing, or, you know, can he do this certain thing, or is it possible? The faith actually is rooted in knowing that he is faithful. That if he is going to say something, that he's going to get it done. And that if you walk with him, you're going to see it get done. You're going to be a part of it getting done. And the beautiful thing about in our Hebrews, even if we aren't there for whatever reason to not see it get done, it's still going to get done. So I say all this to really let you guys know, in this season, everything is coming everywhere, a lot of things that are going, a lot of realities that were kind of suppressed down by, you know, being quiet and this and that and the third, are starting to come out. A lot of situations are starting to affect memories, affect us, affect our work, our money, our all the things that kind of give us peace, if you will, in this world. And God is saying to us, watch out. Beware of the leaven. Watch out. Don't get caught up in trying to figure every little thing out. Pray. Listen. Be obedient. Allow that obedience to be first built up by your faith in who God is. Not what he can do for you, and not his power and his might and his ability, because that's what happens to us. We get caught up on, okay, I know God can heal, I know he is a healer, I know he can do this, that, and the third, I know that he can make a way, and all those things, I know he can do. And then he doesn't, we're kind of like mad at God, like, wait, I know you can do these things, why didn't you? And blah, blah, blah. It's like, you gotta get to know him. Personally, you have that relationship, then you can talk to me about, hey, this is what's going to happen, this is how this is going to work out for you. You know, I don't have any stories right now, but I remember hearing different stories where people just knew that it was their time. People just knew that, you know, a situation was going to pan out the way that it came out, and so they didn't go to that party or go to that place. And it's all because, it's not because God is a fortune teller, it's because they knew who God was, so when he spoke to them, they understood what they were supposed to do. His unhindered obedience is going to yield your ability and unity to be a part of, and even see in some cases, the miracles of God. And I really want to also encourage you, if you're in a place where you're trying to figure it all out, figure out where to put the money, figure out where to do this, figure out what to do with the kids, figure out what to do with the situation, figure out how to get there, figure out how to get here. Listen. Action. Sleep. Now, whatever word you want to use, get into a place where you are getting to know God, and listen, getting to know person. And also, where you are, being obedient to what he's saying to you. So I just want to make sure that so everyone at the Lord that you say. Alright, well, hey, feel at peace. I feel like God has said everything he's wanted to say through this. I really hope it finds you well. I feel that God is doing amazing things in your life right now. I hope this video is really going to help you in your walk with him and your encouragement. And if you're looking for someone to kind of confirm that you need to pray, then hopefully this is that confirmation. And I also just want to let you guys know, check out our Facebook page, Zoom Japan Facebook page. Check it out. And it was great talking to you guys. I hope this is fun. I hope it blesses you.